Good evening, each and every one of you. Today we are here with our brother. We will be talking about some stuff, some important things. As you all know, we have a lot of things that are going on in our country, but we are going to talk about few things that you know, that we can give ideas and we know how best we can deal with the situation. Okay, I'm here with my brother. What's your name?
I'm Saidou.
Saidou.
My name and Baji, that's my surname.
Saidou Baji, welcome to my channel. And
thank you very much, brother.
Okay. So there is questions I want to ask you about the issue of the gender marriage that is going on in the Gambia right now. Mm-hmm. So what's your take on the gender marriage in the Gambia?
My take as an individual.
Yeah.
I think it's a funny situation, you know what I mean, when you see a country like Gambia, you know what I mean, coming up with a story like this one, trying to legalize or make gay a problem or gay as well, like an issue in the country, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's something that we should not even encourage in our country, you feel me?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, it doesn't go with the values of the country, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I think since the Gambia started functioning, there was nothing like this and there was nothing like promoting anything like this one, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So if we reach in a stage whereby you see, they see people talking about it in the country, it's because they get the courage from somewhere else, or they get the call from somewhere else to talk about it.
Yeah.
My take as an individual is it's not something that we should make an issue or we should talk about, because it's not that much important as a nation or as Gambia.
Because there are a lot of people talking about on the social media and on television stations that there are others arguing that it should be allowed because everyone has a right. Every human being should be given his right. What should you say on that one?
They say every human being should be given the right, yeah?
Yeah.
Every human being should be given the right. That's true.
Mm-hmm.
But in a certain level, you know what I mean, not up to this level of introducing or legalizing same married, or you know what I mean,
mm-hmm.
A woman with a woman and a man with a man. It's disgusting, my friend.
Okay.
I think people who are trying to encourage it should go home and sit down and think of themselves, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because without their parents, they will not function in that world or in this world that we live in.
Exactly.
So if you try to encourage something like that, you are trying to encourage like people getting into each other, of not producing or of not giving out child that will, you know what I mean, control the world tomorrow.
Exactly.
Because if same gender are coming to get married or are going to get married, which means no production is gonna happen again.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So people who are promoting this thing should just make a stop. Yeah, it is in other countries. We don't have problem with that. And I don't have problem or if I see a gay to discriminate him or, you know what I mean? But it's not civilized in our nation as Gambians.
Exactly.
Or in Gambia, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think they have to think, rethink about that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, my second question is, how can we avoid it happening in our country?
The best thing we can do to avoid it in our country is to stop talking about it and stop promoting it. That's all. Because if you have some certain people who had to come out or they give them platforms to start promoting something like this, it's nonsense, you know what I mean? I think they have to stop promoting it. Anybody who wants to come in a platform to promote something like this,
mm-hmm.
I don't think they should allow him. They should not even encourage it, you know what I mean? Either a radio station or a television.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? It starts from there. And the other thing is, I think the families should start nurturing their kids training, showing them good home training.
Yeah.
I think it all starts from the homes.
Exactly.
Because if you have a child and you see the way he's going or starting to take a behavior which is strange, I think you as a family or as an individual should try and stop that.
Exactly.
Try to put him in the right way. Teach him good things that tomorrow, even the gayism thing will not come to his head or lesbianism.
Exactly.
I think that's the way we should avoid it.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Okay. The third question is, do you think the Gambian government is involved in this matter? Or with the European Union by signing or by allowing gay and lesbians to have their rights in the Gambia?
You know, the government, I think if we have a very good government, or if the government is strong enough, this will come out and, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Let's say, deny the allegations.
Exactly.
Because if at all the European Union or anybody who comes to Gambia and try to say, like, we have to legalize gayism, the government should be the first people or the first to come out and say, okay, we Gambians, we cannot do anything like that. We respect you as EU, but we as a nation, we have our culture. Mm-hmm. And then we are going by the people, and whatever our people says, that's what we're going to do. And I think the majority of Gambians are against this, you feel me? So the government also made a mistake at that place. Okay, they should first, let's say, when the rumor starts circulating, if I was the president or anybody near the president, you know what I mean, we have to come out and then say, like, okay, we had rumors of gayism or of lesbianism, but we as a government or me as a president, I'm against it. Mm-hmm. And every Gambian should sit and relax because it's not going to happen. You feel me? Mm-hmm. By then the people will understand that the president came out and then give a speech that this thing is not going to happen in the country. You feel me?
Yeah.
That way the government supposed to play that role in that part.
I think that is the reason why the Gambians are complaining, because the government is not taking part still.
Mm.
So I think that is the problem.
Yeah, it's a big issue, you know what I mean? Because a nation like Gambia, I think we have a president. And if a president had something like this in his or her nation, I think the president should come out. Or
exactly.
If not the president, someone near to the president should come out and say, like, what the European or what these people are saying is not going to function in this country, because we are Muslims, Christians, and in our deens, or either being Christian or Muslim,
mm-hmm.
I don't think we do promote something like this.
Okay.
You feel me? It starts. It has to start from them. They have to come out and talk. But if they keep quiet, people will think that they are with the European Union or with the union that is trying to promote this kind of thing. And it's dirty, my brother.
Okay.
We don't want to use foul words to demonstrate how dirty it is. But it's never law and make look cool. That understand that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they have to do something.
Okay, this is what I have for you today. This was the information I want to have from you. And thank you very much for being on my platform. And see you again next time.
Yeah, you're welcome,
thank
brother.
You.
You're welcome, and wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Thanks for the time.
Thank you for your time. See you again.
Yes, ma'am.
For the next
Abarakabaka
episode.
And